Alright, to get started with Kodu, you're going to want to begin by clicking on New World. If you've already started a world, you're going to go to Load World or Resume, but we'll go ahead and get started here from the beginning. And as you load your new world, you'll see it's basically just a green square. A couple of the different tools down here at the bottom that you're going to use a lot, the Hand and Move tool. If you left click with that, you can just move around left or right or forward or backward. But if you right click with that, you'll be able to actually rotate and orbit around your world, which can be really helpful for looking at it from the top or down low and kind of seeing all the way around. For this first tutorial, we're going to be focusing mostly on just the ground, which you'll use the paintbrush to select different colors and paint them onto your world and add more ground. And then the up and down button will let you create some mountains and hills and valleys. And we'll really just be focusing on these first two for this first tutorial. So on the paint button, right now, if I click on it once, you can see the square is about the size that it's going to be painting. So it's a rather large paintbrush. As I click the ground, I can add more ground to my world. If you wanted to do a larger square, you'll use the arrow keys, the right arrow key. It gives you a larger square so you can add more ground at once, or the left arrow key would give you a smaller square so you could do details like a road or a river or something like that on your world. The different brush types on the right, if you click the blue boxes there, you've got a square brush or a round brush, and really those are the two main ones I use. On the other side are your different color choices, and you'll see there are tons and tons of colors and different patterns to choose from. And if you select one, let's say this green one here, that is a square shape, which they're all square shapes, you're going to have a world that looks kind of more like a Minecraft world. So that as I paint my ground on here, if I go to raise that up, which we'll be doing in a little bit, you notice it's very blocky and looks kind of very square. If you select the color and press the down arrow when you're on the color choices, the down arrow has all the same color choices, but these are smooth blocks. And if you see, if you notice, if I paint these now over where I had previously had the much more blocky pieces, now it's a smoother looking ground surface instead of the very blocky looking ground surface. So that's just kind of up to you for preference. There is no real difference in the scoring rubric for one over the other. It just kind of depends on how you want it to look. Sometimes you may have a combination. You may want the smooth surfaces for the mountain areas, but if you're going to build like a little castle building or something like that with a, say a gray, you may want it to actually be the square pieces. And then you could actually raise that up and have an object in your world that does look kind of blocky. So lots of different choices to how you're going to select your different ground colors and styles. So one of the things that you will be scored on is that you've got at least 4 to 5 different colors in your world and that they're well placed and well designed. So to do that, you're going to kind of think about your world and think about where can you use different colors. There's lots of different patterns you could use, different choices there. Some of the ones that I know a lot of students really enjoy are actually at the very end, which is unfortunate because you've got to scroll all the way through them. But the last few actually kind of glow. So if you're looking for something like lava, this red one or this orange one look really nice, or if you're just looking for a really bright colored ground, some of these last ones can look really nice. So let's say I chose this one. I want a smaller brush, so I'll press the left arrow and I can paint kind of some lava into my world. There was another one, I believe number 19, that goes pretty well with that if you want something like kind of on the edge, because when that one gets raised up, it actually kind of has a little bit of orange underneath it, so it kind of looks like dried lava up on the top, but it's still kind of orange on the bottom. So work on adding different colors to your world, Remember, if you want it to have more of a blocky look, you can just press the up arrow when you're selecting the colors. If you want it to be more of a smooth look, just press the down arrow, and you'll have the same color choices, but more of a smooth pattern to them.